we're seeing a big increase in our call volume. In the last 10 years, the last decade, we've seen a 54% increase in our request for service, our demand for service from our community, growing population, aging community, all those types of things. What it really translates into is about 3,900 people experienced a critical emergency, called 911, and had to wait longer than 5.5 minutes for us to get there. Now, why is that important? You know, in a heart attack situation, when you're not getting oxygen to your brain, at the 6-minute mark, you start to slide down the scale and you're not really recoverable at that percentage of time, and your survivability, it really starts to drop quickly. If we get there earlier, we can start CPR, we can administer drugs, we can shock the patient, and your chance for survival increases. So we want to get there sooner in those types of emergencies. In a house fire, the fire doubles in size every minute. So if it starts as a small fire, every minute it doubles in size. And so if it's a room and contents fire, we can put that out. We can conserve the rest of the property. There's little or smaller property damage, smaller insurance claims, and that person can get back in their home a lot quicker. Because time matters, seconds count, and the men and women of the department are dedicated professionals and they want to get there fast every time. But with the increasing call volume, that makes it difficult to cover all the calls at once. The Oregon Pallet Fire was a significant fire. To give you a little bit of perspective about the enormity of that fire was visible from space, from a weather satellite, the heat index. And if you can imagine a football field sized area stacked 50 feet tall with pallets on fire, that's the magnitude of the fire we had to deal with when we got there, and the radiant heat coming off that fire. So it required all of our resources within the city, 11 engines and 2 ladders, and we also requested mutual aid. And we have mutual aid with many of the jurisdictions around us that allows us to respond to the larger type incidents that are resource heavy. We ended up with 16 fire engines and 5 ladder trucks at this incident. Of course, whenever we have a response like that, we're multiple hours and a lot of things going on, we have to take care of the rest of the city and all the calls that continue to happen while we're having this fire. The calls don't stop when you're having a big incident. And in this instance, we had a 1,000-gallon propane tank that was being impinged on by the heat. We had several buildings and many vehicles. We also had the food bank right next door. So you can just imagine how impactful it would be on a community if the food bank burned down. The crews were able to confine the fire to the location it was when they got there. And basically, we say big fire, big water. We were flowing over 7,000 gallons a minute of water under this fire. We had 9 fire hydrants tapped. So lots of resources, lots of people, lots of coordination going on. But we were able to confine that fire to where it started, basically, in the pallet structures. And that business owner was able to get back into business in a few weeks because all of his other property was conserved. The people that we really are seeing the increase in the cardiac save rate are the people who are getting CPR before emergency responders get there. 80% of our cardiac arrests occur in the home, and so if nobody in your family knows CPR, you're waiting until we arrive to start to get CPR. If your children or your wife or your husband knows CPR, they can start CPR on you, and that CPR makes a huge difference. It triples your chance for survival. So that's critically important. The CPR in Schools program, this is a program that's actually been running for 6 years. We're in our 6th year. We've trained nearly 18,000 eighth graders and their parents how to do CPR and how to use an AED. And I can tell you, if you have a heart attack in Salem in front of an eighth grader, they're going to jump in and do CPR on you. They're that confident with it. In 2019, our cardiac save rate for somebody who had a witnessed arrest and somebody did CPR on them and they were in a shockable rhythm and they walked out of the hospital with no neurological deficit back to their family was 50%. National average is 32. So great, we're above the national average. But we really want to do better than that. We want to be the best in the nation. And the best in the nation is about 80%. So next year, we're going to be rolling out a new exciting program that's going to help us raise that cardiac save rate and hopefully get us above that 80% number.